In this question, we are going to solve the differential equation. Here, for the given differential equation, it is a second order differential equation, d square y by dx square minus n into n plus 1 y by x square equal to 0. When n is constant, the product of two independent solutions, because it's a second order differential equation, it have two solutions. We need to find the product of the two solutions. To find that one, we want to write the approximate solution. We don't know exactly what is the solution, the approximate solution of this differential equation. Then we need to form the auxiliary equation. Then if you are solving the auxiliary equation, you can get the exact solution. Then you have to multiply the two independent solution to find the answer. So we are forming the trial solution, that is y of x for the given differential equation, that would be equal to some constant. We don't know exactly what is the amplitude of the solution. We are making that amplitude is constant 10 times the x power m. This would be the approximate solution for the given differential equation. Now we can substitute this one in the given differential equation. Before that, just we can rearrange this differential equation. How we can rearrange means, this is our given differential equation, d square y by dx square plus, it would be simply minus n into, n is a constant here, n plus 1 into y divided by the x square equal to 0. This is a given differential equation. If you multiply the whole differential equation by x square, the first term is x square times the same differential operator d square y by dx square. This is a standard differential equation minus n into n plus 1 into y equal to 0. So this would be the after multiplying the given first differential equation by x square, the whole equation, now it will be like that. Now what we have to do, we can substitute the chosen trial solution in this equation. So the first term is x square, you can keep as it is, d square y by dx square, just you have to differentiate this y. So I suppose if you are differentiating this y, the y prime represents the first order differential equation with respect to x, dy by dx, that's represented by y prime. What it will do, it's a constant, it won't act do anything with constant, but the power will reduce by 1. So m times x power m minus 1. Suppose if you are differentiating the second time, the y double prime, what it will do, see, it won't to, there is a cm front side, the power will come to the left hand side, then it will reduce the power one more. So y power m minus 2, this is the y double prime, because here y double prime is represented by d square y by dx square. If you are substituting that value, here m times m minus 1, this is a value, in times the y power m minus 2, make the bracket. So here m minus 2, this is a that one. The remaining factor n into n plus 1, the y we have chosen c times x power m. Actually I forgot to put here each differential equation, there is an it's right. Now what it will go here, not y power m minus 2, it's actually here x power m minus 2. I mistakenly put that on, so here also it is x power m minus 2, then this would be equal to 0. Now what we can do, we can multiply the x square, here x power m minus 2, so here plus 2. If you are multiplying, you have to sum the power, m minus 2 plus 2, minus 2 plus 2, it will get cancelled. So you will get There is one more factor we are missing, c here, because it's a c time m into m minus 1. So m into m minus 1, here c time x power m only will be there, minus n into n plus 1 c time x power m, that would be equal to 0. Now what we can do, we can take the c time x power m commonly out, c time x power m we can take commonly out. So inside we have m into m minus 1 minus n into n plus 1, that would be equal to 0. So c times m power n is commonly out, so you can make the bigger bracket. So anyway, the solution would be 0, because the solution have definitely it's a, we have chosen the non-zero solution, it will obey this dynamical equation. The solution, it can't be equal to 0, that means c x power m cannot be equal to 0, this is cannot be equal to 0. So the only way we can choose this one equal to 0, then only the product goes to 0. So you can make this is the auxiliary equation. In the mathematics we will say the zero factor in the trial solution, it's an auxiliary equation. So now we need to solve this auxiliary equation. For that, just we can expand this equation by multiplying inside, or by just simplifying this one, m times m plus 1, it is m square minus m. Just I have multiplied the m inside the m minus 1, minus n into n plus 1. Anyway, n is constant, that's why we are not expanded that one. You can keep as it is. Now this is a second quadratic equation. Now we can find the solution for the quadratic equation. Then we have the two roots after solving this one. The two roots, if you are substituting this y equal to c x power m, we will get the exact solution. So we have that m square minus m minus n into n plus 1 equal to 0. This is the auxiliary equation we have. Now to find the roots of this quadratic equation, we know what it will do. So there are two roots we will get. You can call m 1 comma 2, that would be equal to the common formula, the minus b. Suppose if you have the quadratic equation like that, a x square plus b x plus c equal to 0. The solution of this quadratic equation, the x equal to the coefficient minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2e. This is a solution for this quadratic equation. Now we are going to use this tool here. So minus b, the b coefficient is here minus 1, so minus of minus 1 plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac. Here b square is minus 1 whole square, it is plus 1 minus 4. Here a coefficient is, the m square coefficient is 1, so a c is minus n into n plus 1. So here we can just cut this one up to here. So this square root will be here, thereby here we can use the same curves painting option. So here thereby 2a here the coefficient is 1. So the same exactly, suppose x, if you are comparing this with this equation, the here it is m. So hence the m is equal to minus of minus 1 it is plus 1, plus or minus square root of 1, the minus 4 times minus n it will be plus, so 1 plus 4. Here if you are multiplying it's n square plus n, so 4n square plus 4n, this would be the inside the square root divided by the 2. Hence 1 plus or minus square root of here a square plus b square plus 2ab, that means you can just make it a 2n plus 1 whole square. Just look at that, if you are expanding to n plus 1 you will arrive exactly this one, 1 plus 4n square plus 4n divided by 2. So here the square root, the square will get cancelled, then 1 plus or minus it's simply 2n plus 1, you can make the bracket divided by the 2. So there are two solutions. So the first solution you can call the in center one is plus, that will be m1. So 1 plus 2n plus 1 divided by 2. So this would be the first solution. If you are simplifying this first solution, you will get like a 1 plus 1 it is 2, 2n plus 2 in the numerator, 2n plus 2 divided by 2. If you are commonly take the 2 outside, if you are dividing, then final answer you will get m1 is n plus 1. This is the first answer. Now the second one, what you got to do for finding the m2, choose the center sign is minus, so 1 minus 2n plus 1 divided by 2. So 1 minus 2n minus 1, just I have multiplied the center minus to the inside divided by 2. 1 minus 1 it will get cancelled, then if I divide with 2 the m2, the second one is minus n simply. So there are two independent solutions we are getting here. The first independent solution, now you can just write the first independent solution, the y1, y equal to we have chosen c times x power m. The first independent solution you can call c times x power m1. So c is a some constant, doesn't matter. Maybe you can choose the first independent solution, constant is c1. So x power m1, m1 we got it's a n plus 1, so x power n plus 1. Now the second independent solution we are getting y2 equal to, you can call the coefficient is z2, the constant, x power m2, we have the m2 is minus n, so c2 x power minus n. This is the second independent solution. So we have these two solutions. Now what we can do, you can, they are asking the product of the two solutions. So the product is y1 times y2, that would be equal to the first coefficient c1, the second coefficient c2. The first solution x factor is x power n plus 1, the second solution x power is x power minus n. So here the product it will be c1 c2 x power, because the power you have to sum, the if the bases are common, n plus 1 minus n, so you can cancel plus n minus n. So finally you will arrive c1 c2 x power 1. This is the product of the two solution. So finally you can choose the product of the two independent solution is proportional to y2 y1 or y1 y2 is proportional to the x. So if you are finding the x, that would be the right answer. Hence the right choice is it's b, it is the product of its two independent solution, it is proportional to x, the b is the right answer.